Hello and welcome to the accounting part of our session today. So what we will be covering, just in a real quick summary, we're talking about general rules, the UAE VAT system, just a little bit brief to understand where businesses that we work with usually struggle or what they normally do. And then we're talking about the different accounting softwares and in what sense that applies to, for example, your startup business, your SME, or as well once you're scaling your business. Now, in terms of general rules of accounting, the main rules in terms of accounting are basically administered within the Ministry of Economy within the UAE. That means it's a centralized government body that governs these rules, meaning certain steps like the financial year. So for you to know, 1st of January until 31st of December is one financial year. As a classification, we have 5 years of bookkeeping regulation. That means we have to be keeping our books, our little invoices and our contracts, anything with the customers in terms of business, we need to keep that for 5 years. There's a bookkeeping proof of concept for that, and we need to have those either digitally or printed, that doesn't matter. Now, in terms of another general rules of accounting, what is important for you to know, if you're opening your business banking account, you most probably have noticed that the name of your account has to be the license name one by one. So there is no option of, let's say, changing your name in the bank account a little bit to make it fit. It will create a lot of problems. We have seen companies in the early stages that were struggling to, like one letter difference or two letters difference, that were really getting a bit of a problem once it came later on to more accounting related points and all over in terms of cohesiveness between the bank account and your systems. So just make sure from the beginning that those points are set up, because that can lead to unnecessary hiccups later that you won't be needing, definitely not. We don't want you to have them. Now, another point of the accounting general rules would be reports, right? The UAE government may or may not sometimes do a sampling on your business, and they will be asking for audited reports. So if your business, and you will most probably find out that due to a free zone, let's say if you're administered by Ajman Free Zone or by Fujairah Free Zone, they have the specific rules and they will be telling you, okay, in order to renew your license, you have to get financially audited, right? So a lot of businesses that start and that are very excited, like probably you are excited now, they don't think of the next steps, what's going to be inside of the, let's say, small print within those free zones. So please make sure to check with the respective free zone if they would be needing an audited finance year. And if they do, then please make sure to have it in place. On another part, what you can evaluate or what touches a bit on accounting is also the UAE VAT, right? I'm not going to deep dive in that. I'm just going to give you a high level of understanding of how we handle it with businesses we work with and how we usually approach that on a very straightforward way. The UAE VAT was introduced into on a federal level in the UAE on the 1st of January 2018. So what does that mean? Like, concept wise, looking at the UK or any other European country, we're charging tax on a service or on a product. That tax that we're charging the customer will then be paid by us to the government authority, which means it's a direct divertible tax that comes from the consumer to the government. So it's not an extra income on us as a company, or it's not an extra benefit to accredit to your accounting, but it's like a post of payment that runs through your accounting just to be paid to the government. Now, why I'm telling you this? Because a lot of people are thinking, oh, I have to be VAT registered because my company will be seen as a more sophisticated company in the UAE. And that probably now after almost a year and a half of having the VAT within the UAE, we see a very interesting change in that direction. Many people actually that are VAT registered are getting to be more credible in terms of their vendors or in terms of their clients they're pitching for. So if you have a business in the UAE and you want to go on a corporate level and work with corporate customers or a bit more, let's say, contracting them on larger scale of manufacturing or whatever contracts you might want to have or products that you want to sell, make sure that you evaluate your business of the VAT compatibility. And how you do that, actually within a calendar year, you should be having 375,000 dirham of turnover transactions, basically sales, or you should be at least having 178,000, which is half of the amount, to voluntarily register. So again, to recap, 375,000 a year plus more makes you mandatory to be registered for VAT in the UAE. Anything below that, but definitely more than 178,000, will give you the opportunity to register voluntarily for the VAT in the UAE. Now, probably you. So nonetheless, what you can tell about UAE and VAT, what most of the Shopify users that we deal with or work with, and what we can recommend on Shopify as a platform or even Shopify Plus, is that the VAT applicability in the system is very easy, very straightforward. So you can just basically add the country and add the 5% on top of it. So it's very seamlessly integrated in the platform. There's no hiccups or whatsoever. So that's a good thing to know in terms of whether you're already registered for VAT or you're planning to in the future. Now, we'll be having a quick dive into the accounting softwares. I'll be telling you a little bit what are the main differences and probably as well what are the advantages in a short sense. So just to name a few, there are definitely more out than these, but these are the ones we usually come across the most dominant within the Middle East, I would say, not only within the UAE. And probably it's a bit small, but we're starting from around the startup, small and mid-sized companies, scaling up onto the large company sector, the bigger companies. Now, that would probably more go into an ERP. That's why I've written ERP. But what I want you to know is, starting off, if you're starting your business or looking into starting your business today and you have not settled for accounting, just have a look through these. Starting off with QuickBooks. QuickBooks is a cloud-based accounting software that is 80% used by small businesses, startups, and small to mid-sized layered businesses. QuickBooks has different plans that enable a lot of flexibility. They're super, super familiar. Why? Because their intuitive interface and online activity, so you can go from the phone, print the invoices, be very, very interactive. It's a very, very nice software to work with. We have worldwide around 2 million users on QuickBooks, so that I would say probably QuickBooks is one of the largest small-sized accounting software that integrates, as far as we know, very well into Shopify. Now, on all of those platforms, what I'm going to tell you are on all of those softwares, please reach out to Shopify, either in Shopify App Store to check if there is already an existing connection that can synchronize your data, or reach out to the provider directly, which means if QuickBooks doesn't have in plan 1, 2, 3 a certain solution on Shopify, you should definitely be reaching out to them. Now, first and foremost, coming to QuickBooks, giving you a little bit of a hint what we have seen in terms of starting rates. It's a very affordable cost. So we're talking about around 70 dirham per month to kick off with that software. And I think that's a very well invested 70 dirham if you're looking for a very well solid, a small accounting program. Now, similar if not almost same, I would say is zero. It's as well cloud-based, it's as well for small businesses. It has the same relation in terms of Shopify integrations. It is used for smaller businesses originated from the UK. So there is definitely a applicability in terms of the VAT, 5% EU VAT, such as QuickBooks as well. So there is no problems in terms of invoicing, raising VAT, credit noting, whatsoever you have to do or whatever when it comes to your accounting, can definitely do that on zero, the same level as in QuickBooks. Now, talking about Zoho, just to give you an idea why we're mentioning Zoho here, Zoho is one of the few softwares that we're mentioning that are FTA accredited, which means they're Federal Tax Authority accredited in the country and as well in the Middle East, giving you a little bit of an edge or advantage if you're looking to be basing your accounting out of the UAE. And it's a fairly easy to use. It has other systems like Zoho Marketing or Zoho CRM, so there are a little bit of more flexibility that can help your small to mid-sized business to have sort of add-ons that will also offer services other than accounting that can seamlessly integrate within Zoho. Talking about Sage is as well similarly comparable, I would say, what we're seeing across the region and the merchants that we work with, similar to QuickBooks, Xero and Zoho. So I would basically say the first four are basically the ones that are usually mostly get selected by startups or SME businesses that are in the fairly early to mid stage of their business that are just having an easy go-to place or easy go-to software that can help them in their day-to-day accounting needs. Now, what is probably to say about Sage, which is a little bit of different to other platforms, it has a more complex or a more, let's say, I don't want to say difficult, but let's say more complex, more in-depth user interface. That means probably in the first three, QuickBooks, Xero and Zoho, once you're logging in, you have a very, very simple, very nice, straightforward user dashboard. You can find your way and navigate very easily through the software. In Sage, it's a bit more complex. Why? Because also it allows you to be a bit more in-depth on certain stages, but it's all basically company base to base. So if you feel that can be a fit in terms of SME, then definitely Sage is one of those two. Now, looking at Tally, it's actually a very interesting thing in our region in the Middle East. We're seeing a lot of businesses being on Tally. Tally is originated from India. It's a software that has been developed there, and it claims to be the complete business management solution. So basically, we're not talking only about accounting, but as well business management for the region. Now, I would say Tally is doing a fairly good job, looking at around 1 million users across the globe, which is definitely already proving its concept. Now, why does it probably work well with the UAE and the UAE market, because it's widely used here, is the capability of scalability between small to mid-sized level of business. So that's just a fact that we're seeing it, we're working with it, and as I said, across integrations for the first five, it's reaching out to Shopify App Store or reaching out directly to the solution provider. But we do know that most of them actually have a very good system to work for you. Now, to probably talk a bit more about the mid to large companies, is just to tell you in the very early stages or in the beginning that where am I now and where can I be in the future? What can I do? Up to which point probably one of the solutions is workable for me, and from which point I should probably be taking on a more, let's say, in-depth and a more ERP or a more larger, more complex business-related accounting software. So, first one we would like to talk about, because we're seeing Microsoft Navision at the moment going to be Microsoft Business Central. So we're seeing that basically predominantly in the retail industry in the UAE. It's a perfect fit. It has a beautiful system, a richness of data, a richness of features that can be used within the platform. It's around 200,000 users around the globe, and it definitely gives an edge to your mid to larger business. And once you're outgrowing the smaller stage, it's a very beautiful situation of flexibility within the platform, very beautiful interface, and very solid structure, very solid accounting to work with. You probably might think it starts actually quite expensive, but it doesn't. So let me tell you here the beauty about Microsoft Navision is available up starting from $70 a month, which is really not breaking the bank, and looking at a consideration of how much you can scale or fit, that's definitely a good to know opportunity within Microsoft. Now, the next step would be also talking a bit about Microsoft AX, and as it comes across to be more of an ERP software, and we would just like to clarify something here. Whereas, as I mentioned, Microsoft Navision is more focused on the retail side of things. That's where we're seeing a big numbers of the UAE retailers basically searching for those solutions. As well, Microsoft AX is predominantly strong in larger companies, but as well, it's usually needed, or it's usually chosen as well if you are manufacturing goods, because it has very in-depth features on terms of manufacturing rather than retailing. So that's a bit of understanding the differences and knowing where to look at. If you're, let's say, a manufacturer, you would probably look at more at Microsoft AX. If you're more a retailer, doesn't matter if that's a software, or if it's an online or a physical product, you'd be probably talking more about Navision. Now, I don't want to confuse you. It's just to name those and to easily scale them to understand what could be a fit for my business at a certain stage. Have a look at those. If there is any concerns, rewatch the video again. Most of the features, and that what we can say from our expertise in the market, is definitely what I've just told you.